10 guaranteed steps that make you a topper. These are not interpretations, these are going to be facts. If you listen carefully, you might get into the best colleges, score the highest marks, maintain those scores, and even clear any freaking competition. Topping in any exam isn't actually hard. The truth is, you would like to top. You've entertained the idea, but you don't seriously want to. And that's why you haven't. Let's hear the 10 reasons why. 1. Study doesn't just happen. I'm sorry, most students live in the illusion that they will just start studying a few weeks before the exams and score the desired marks. When the time comes and you sit to study, you hate it. Can't find any interest in it. Crib about not finding any focus. Start thinking about girls and then hate yourself for thinking about girls. Hate your friends who are studying. Talk to the ones who always score well and then worry because they're way ahead of you. Invite stress because the course or syllabus is too large to cover. You know why all of this shit happens? Because studying doesn't just happen. It's a habit. Habits are built over time. Instead of building the habit of studying, you've been daily building other habits. And suddenly, when you change your routine and demand from your brain to focus on studies, it gets confused. You wonder, why am I thinking about girls when I want to study? Because you've been thinking about girls daily. That's a habit you've built over a long period of time, which won't disappear on demand. That's not how the brain works. It simply does as trained. Those who say they study for one night and score well are bullshitting you. There are no tricks, schemes, or mind games, but the simple truth of life. Everything comes from hard work. A fact you're going to learn years later. 2. Inclination. Let's be honest here. Nobody's born with a natural inclination to study. What we want to do is play games, have fun with our friends, get loads of girlfriends, look incredibly good, and have women dying for us. Show off to everybody, become famous in school or college, have rolls of cash lying around, get cars, drink all day, do drugs, and possibly date porn stars. At that age, that's how guys think. We are dumb as cattle. Yes, I agree there is a 1% student population obsessed with studies, but I am talking in general. My point here is, you do what your inclinations are. If you're interested in porn stars, you will have hard disks filled with porn. If you're interested in fun, you'll drink, do drugs with your buddies. And if you're interested in girls, you'll be sending random friend requests, chatting with strangers, checking out their pictures, spending night and day on such adventures. If you want to top, then that will have to become your inclination. Which leads us to point 3. We have our interests stupidly distributed. Why does this world quantitatively have such a large amount of average students? Are they all dumb? No. According to me, most people are dumb because they choose to remain dumb. It's not an affliction. You have to understand, to get better in anything, the one and only thing you need to do is practice. Practice in itself includes hard work. And it's not that you aren't practicing. Oh yes, you are. But they're all stupid, useless things. Why? Because you haven't consciously chosen anything in your life yet. You're chasing girls because you're a sexual being. Sadly, falling in love and craving sex are just hormones screwing with your mind. More than half of your other interests are tied with social anxiety, approval, and herd instinct to be part of a group. This is why you drink when you don't want to, try drugs, and tolerate people in your group that you hate. And lastly, there is the want to be recognized, appreciated, to be a social hero, which you're going to translate as being cool. All of this might sound a little boring to you, but you know why I'm telling you this? It is because none of the things that you're doing are chosen by you. Every guy at your age does the same shit, goes through all these phases, gets his heart broken, and then emerges confused in life. Why do you think older men or guys always say, "Beta, tumhari umr mein humne bhi sab bahut kiya hai"? Because they actually have. They're not saying it to be cool in front of you. They are stating a fact. Being cool in reality is actually being like everybody else. Sadly, there is nothing cool about being cool because everybody has already fucked their lives trying to be cool. But you are in luck because none of those guys had someone like me explaining this shit in the manner I'm explaining it to you right now. So listen carefully. Whatever you're doing, which you may think is unique and cool, it isn't. All your current interests aren't chosen by you, at least not consciously, unless they're artistic or creative. So make a conscious choice. Choose studying as an interest. All the really cool people, the geniuses, the ones who are immortal, they all made this choice. So I'm just saying. 4. Impulse versus resolve. The problem with most of you is not that you don't plan or want to study, but whenever you decide, at the last moment, you do something else. In simple terms, you have too many distractions around you in forms of people. You're about to study, But some friend comes to your place and then you spend hours chatting with him. You're studying, you receive texts in groups from friends, you get tagged online, you are involved in all sorts of bullshit. You're hearing too many stories every day. Stories about girls, stories about fights, about some cool guys you want to be like, about what he did and what that guy did and this guy. The funny part is, you don't even think about it. Man, they're my friends. They will never qualify as time waste. Their problems are my problems. We are pros. Why do you think people who actually crack the IITs and IIMs shut themselves in a room, only interact with those with similar pursuits and aren't really active on social medias? Because one word, priorities. I've said this before and in thousands of years to come, this will remain unchanged. Priorities is what leads a man to glory and similarly to destruction. If girls, porn, gaming, drinking, drugs and fun with friends are your priorities, you will most probably meet the latter. 5. Your life isn't planned. It's no mystery. You have filled your life with losers. You're getting affected by anything happening around you. So I need to tell you this. Your parents are right on this one thing. You need to plan. In order for planning to happen, it requires isolation, research, self-questioning, self-estimation, recognition of the goals, period of time, scheduling, routine building, time wasted, scanning the sources of time wastage, capacity to work, and the work to be done. All these things get automatically figured out by simply sitting down and planning. I hope you better start doing it as soon as this video is over. 6. You believe in living in the moment. We all want the best for ourselves, but the best often has two definitions, best for you and best for your life. At a given time, many things can be best for you, but not best for your life. For example, I have a friend who is a womanizer. He goes from one girl to another, as a result, wasting a lot of time. To him, it was the best thing, dating all these hot girls. As years passed, he found out that he had ruined his career, was nowhere close to the position he had envisioned, got severely depressed, the girls left him for better guys, and now he's single and broke. Another example is all those guys who talk to their exes to feel better. Because talking to that person helps them with their depression or heartache doesn't mean it's the best thing for their life. It's the opposite. But because it actually helps, it becomes the best thing for them to do in the moment. Let's apply this on you. You actually know the best things for your life. You already have colleges planned in your mind, the percentage in high school, 12, college, your GPA in college, companies you want to get into. At any stage, you know what the best thing for your life is, but you constantly sabotage it, destroy it for things that are best for you in the moment. How do I know that? Well, that brings me to point 7. Tell me, what did you learn when you could not get into the colleges you had chosen or couldn't score well in an exam? Nothing. You compromised and started doing the same thing again. Made big goals and engaged in things that made you happy in the moment. Drugs, girls, friends, gaming, movies, TV shows, and I'm tired of repeating this list. Start learning from your mistakes instead of lowering your standards. In any educational systems, we have exams, tests, reports, and assessments of our performance several times a year, which clearly tell us if we are meeting our expectations or not. Now let me tell you this. Your expectations are the most accurate and credible assessment of your abilities done by your mind. So if you underperform, instead of accepting the results as your standards, learn what the mistakes were, where you lagged, and what you need to focus on. 8. You accepted that you are a mediocre student the moment you were put into the category of average students by your teacher or some authority. You didn't have a problem with that term, average. It did not ignite a fire in your chest. The problem is that most of you have accepted that you are an average student, and on a usual basis, that's how you refer to yourself. Explain this to me. How can you be a topper if you've already accepted you are mediocre? When you make this admission, you simply erase the possibility that you can score the highest or even among the highest. You look for average colleges and institutions. You set your bar down. You start aiming low. Look for average firms. Accept yourself as a middle class earner. Aim for middle class luxuries. Now understand this. With a single categorization done by a fucking stranger that you accepted as gospel truth about your reality, you changed your entire life. Just because some teacher, your parents, or some fucking stranger thought you were average, you accepted that label? Reject them. Fuck them. They don't get to decide who you are. You do. Put yourself on the top because that's where you belong. When you approach the world with this mindset, you take on the challenges and not compromise or lower your standards like a loser. 9. You fool yourself, thinking you are a creative genius or street smart because there are just too many articles calling idiots who waste time in doing pranks, fun, drinking, giving shit to their teachers and professors smart in different ways. I'm sorry, here's the truth, because clearly nobody wants to tell you this. If you continue on this path, you're going to fail in life. hard, and that nerd in your class you call a dumbass for always studying is going to get a great job, marry a motherfucking hot chick, drive a great car, and have a great life. I'm sorry, but these are the facts of life, not my interpretations. Your parents are not going to frame it like this, so I am. Get your shit together as soon as you can. 10. You are not motivated. And in long term, nobody can help you with that. This is the truth. You know why? Because it's your life. We can tell you how and why. But at the end of the day, the decision is yours. Nobody's going to do shit on your behalf. The only people who truly care about you are your parents. Nobody else gives a shit about you. After this video ends, I will be gone working on my next video. Now, what you can do is get all riled up, study for 5-6 hours at a stretch, and go back to your bullshit routine tomorrow. Or you can really apply what the 10 steps are saying, the 10 habits, the 10 do's and don'ts, and carefully plan ahead. Change your life, build a routine, come up with your own ideas, stop latching on to others for help. Become cautious about your life, cautious of whom you're inviting, dating, befriending. Like I said in my first point, it's hard work. But brother, if you want to be at the top, you will have to start doing what none of the others are doing. Ending this point, how do you get motivated daily? If you seek motivation, then look at the things that you want to change, that alone should burn a fire in your heart. Why the fuck am I living in this shitty house? I deserve better. I hate the clothes that I'm wearing or the amount of clothes I own. I hate that I can't afford a better, faster internet connection. I hate that I'm not able to eat whatever I want any day I wish. We are all living in limitations. Those limitations should motivate the fuck out of you. You only watch motivational videos as an addiction. Not because you want to change stuff, you don't want to change shit, you're comfortable. You need motivation to change your life? How about you just step outside your house, look at the world, and question your insignificance in it. Are you satisfied with your current state, the house you live in, your bank account, your car, or whatever you drive, the cash in your pocket, your computer, cell phone, everything? Are you satisfied, or do you want more or better? In these things, you will find your daily motivation. Now, you might complain, but you didn't give us any tricks on how to study. You already know how to study. There is no magic involved. Plus, you've already watched several videos on those studying tips and motivation. Tell me, how did it turn out? Follow this video. How to study management already come under planning. You are a master planner. You just never took care of the shit that destroys your plans. And this video is about that. It's not enough to have a vision. You have to take harsher steps to protect it. I'm sorry if I've offended you with the language. I had no such intentions. But I had every single intention to shake you to the core. Have a great day, and more importantly, have a great, rich life.